In this video, we will talk about the DJI Mini 2 SDK and a possible release date. If you don't know what it is that I'm talking about, then feel free to watch the rest of the video as I will fill you in. Welcome to another video. I'm Henrik Olsen, and if you want to learn how to make better videos with your camera and drone in general, then consider subscribing to my weekly tips, tests, and tutorials. You probably heard this many times that I talk about a SDK, especially when I use third-party apps like Litchi and latest the Chinese app that was called Rainbow to fly the Mavic Mini. The SDK is short for Software Development Kit, and it's basically a set of commands that DJI makes available so third-party vendors can access the drone. So if you want to connect something like Litchi to the DJI Mini 2, this requires that DJI releases the SDK. So far, they have not done that for the DJI Mini 2. It's available for the Air 2 and it's available for the Mavic Mini, but not yet for the Mini 2. This is often a frequently asked question that I get when I publish videos with the Mavic Mini showing that I can fly waypoints, I can do active track, at least to some extent using this app. This will of course extend the usability of the Mini 2 tremendously when we get access to this. So far, if you go to the DJI developer website and find the roadmap for the SDK, no indication was to be found that they will be supporting the Mini 2 anytime soon. Taking a closer look at the roadmap revealed that 4.15, the version of the mobile SDK, was estimated to be released 21st of June. So I'm not really sure if they already released it, but at least 4.15 does not contain support for the Mini 2. I will make sure to link to the DJI developer page so you can sign up for yourself and gain access to the latest roadmap for the SDK. So as I've stated in previous videos, I thought all hope was out for DJI deciding to do this. Because you could say adding all these extra features to the DJI Mini 2, that would basically position it a little bit closer to some of the more expensive drones that DJI of course wants to push as they earn a lot more money on these. I was actually under the impression that they have decided not to do this. Until one of you guys wrote me a comment below one of the videos. A channel that is called Small World Big Things shared two really interesting sources of information that indicates when we might see the SDK coming out. And if we look at the first link, that is to the Git repository that DJI is currently using as part of the mobile development app. The GitHub is, or GitHub, repository is a way for companies to control their versioning, and you can basically write tickets in here in regards to software releases. If we scroll down here to the middle, we would see some really crucial piece of information. It's basically an update from DJI developer support that confirms that the support of the DJI Mini 2 will not be part of the 4X roadmap, but will be included in the 5.0. So the mobile SDK 5.0 will contain support for Mini 2. Now the big question is, when is this going to happen? This is where we're going to check the second link provided. And that one goes directly to the DJI forum. This goes to a thread that is labeled SDK update for Mini 2, where users since 2020 have been discussing and wishing for DJI to support this. And if we scroll down here, then at some point we will stumble across the final piece that we need to know, at least an indication when this could happen. Let me just see if I can find it here. So then there's this post. One of the members have reached out to the DJI developer support and basically got this answer that they had a meeting with the product team yesterday and the ETA of the 5.0 of the mobile SDK is scheduled for sometimes during September. So if this is true, DJI will release support for the SDK for DJI Mini 2 sometimes during September. This is not as soon as many of us have hoped, but at least it's better than not supporting it. So this was just a short update of the rumors that is around the SDK support for the Mini 2. In case you have heard something else or have additional rumors that you want to share with me, then feel free to share them in the comments below. In case you want to check out what is possible when there is full SDK support, I've made a video with a playlist with all the videos that I made around using the Litchi app and the Mavic Mini. In case you want to access those videos, you could do that through this card. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then feel free to give it a like. If you didn't like it, feel free to press the dislike button twice. Thank you for watching, and I'll be seeing you around.